See, so she goes like this.
Don't let her family.
It's all about actions, anyway. Okay, I said for you, that's just an option. I advise Councillor Christopher Blake. I'm gonna read out the statements.
Thank you. Can you tell me what sort of time I have to speak to the committee?
5 minutes.
Okay. And do I have a right reply of the local council?
Yes.
Yes, thank you.
Before you start, I just want to give a statement that we've had to advise from legal. We're here to debate the value of the green card. I've been advised by the Borough Solicitor that we should not be discussing particular sites or planning applications which are for the planning committee to decide. Those members of the committee who are also on the planning committee are reminded that they should not say anything that may be seen as prejudging any planning application. Nor should members of the planning committee say anything that might give the impression that they have closed their minds to applications to develop green belt sites. In law, this is allowed in special circumstances, which have to be considered on a case-by-case basis. So can I just ask members to not make references to planning applications? Thank you. Chris?
Thank you, Chair, members. Strangely, Andy, you mentioned that, and we start by saying I'm aware of the potential sensitivity issues around green belts and planning, as will discharge that type of function. So I will not be referring to any specific planning application this evening. That is not the purpose of this notice of mention. Will GDP has a whole series of policies, over 20, relating to green belts. Well, I suppose the one that's most relevant to this notice of mention is GB2, which is guidelines for development in the green belt. I'm sure many of us as elected members have all had applications in our wards that relate to green belts. I think it's a pretty safe bet that we will all have had varying levels of concern, I would say in most cases, levels of opposition supporting our residents and opposing development in green belts. What this notice of motion seeks to do is give protection to council owned green belt sites. After all, if we allow council green belt to be developed, but refuse applications from private individuals and companies, that sends a really bad message. Therefore, I was delighted when I read the word loan. The legal council, my official legal council, stated quite clearly, I'm not prepared to allow our green belt land to be built on. I am resolute about that commitment. It is a jewel in Wills Crown and greatly valued by residents. Chair, I think it's really good when parties come together on a common issue. And I'm sure the Conservative Party is with the Leader of the Council and the Labour Party in opposing development of the green belt. Green belt is valuable. As well as providing much needed recreational space, it acts as a natural buffer between our villages, towns and communities. And given that there is a shortfall in recreational urban green space in Whittle, I believe it's incumbent on us as a council to lead by example and protect our green belts. That's all I have to say, Chair, because I think the motion says it all. And I hope the committee can support this notice of motion in its entirety. Thank you.
Thanks, Chair.
Just make it quite clear, as a member of the planning committee, I go into every planning committee on my own, every issue that is discussed, whether it be green belt or not. I have a great deal of sympathy with Councillor Blake here and sentiments in and around green belt. I do think the actual words of the notice of motion could have been better. They do make reference, despite what Councillor Blakely said, and he didn't mention, did make reference to some issues. However, I think it's not sensible, or it wouldn't be sensible for this committee to be seen either in the scrutiny role or any other role to A, deem to be pseudo planning committee, or B, actually the policy making committee of the council. We advise, we please scrutinise policies, and there's a number of policies that are relevant to this issue. One being the national policy guidance, which obviously overarches everything. There's also the emerging core strategy plan, which I believe is shortly to be announced and released and consulted on, which is also part of the wider debate. And there are circumstances, I understand, under both pieces of emerging legislation and particularly national legislation, that Greenbelt can be developed. It's not, it's never, ever in a day. And there are historic positions on the riddle where some of our great developments have had to make way. It's, to my knowledge, our Park Hospital was built on the campus at that point in time, Greenbelt land, and the extensions there and car park extensions have gone through planning committee in the past. So there are circumstances where for greater good things like that can take place. Secondly, it is also my belief that the entire Classic Bridge Hospital site is within the Greenbelt band. I dare say we would see as a special circumstance maybe a massive extension of the Castle Bridge or a massive research facility there associated with the hospital as you know as something hypothetically that would be different. So I don't think it's wise for this committee to totally endorse neither ignore the notice of motion. So I think I would be happy to listen to all the debate about how we take this notice of motion, we are being genuine, in the spirit that it's meant in terms of helping guide policy, helping Twiddle be in a position where it can react legally and positively to whatever the future may hold. Other authorities have taken quite a different view. I remember, not a political issue, but Chester, released a huge swathe of green belts as part of their urban and economic development plan, because they had all the land lobby, they had all the land to develop in terms of the area around the city of Chester. I noticed across the water, notably, have released quite a bit of land for one of these garden villages under the scheme to build 1,500 homes. So there are circumstances where things like that can take place. I'm not saying that is the future for Will, I'm just saying that the council has to have well thought out, well rehearsed, well consulted policies to be able to arm itself whatever the circumstances are. No circumstances are not capable. So therefore, I think the wise line would be to perhaps endorse the value or make some sort of statement about we endorse the value of Greenbelt and all that it offers. I don't quote me on figures because it looks like everything you say will be come back to notice of motion in the future. But we are randomizing. From an aerial view, we look at about some 40% is green, and that's what makes it a special place and what makes it a very attractive place. And we aren't, I don't think, under any circumstances, talking about whole scale development of that or actually changing the nature of the world. I don't believe that's an option for us. But just to reiterate, as a member of the planning committee, I would listen to any sensible argument, as we must as a planning authority, listen to any sensible argument. Develop pays his fee and turns up the plan with the plan application, and we are duty bound by law to actually hear that plan application. So I think it's very, very perhaps well meaning. The fact that it's been linked, not my words, the words of the resolution, but linked to a current issue, haven't helped probably sensible debate as much as it could have.
Thank you,
Chair.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Chair. I've got a couple of problems here. First of all, as a member of the Overview and Scrutiny Committee, I'm not clear in my mind whether this committee tonight has got the right from the authority to actually determine a policy on redevelopment as outlined in this motion. Also, Chair, going back to the statement you read out at the beginning, that no reference should be made to individual planning considerations. The second paragraph of this motion refers to council-owned land in Sogo or Massey, and then it talks about this committee confirming unconditional guarantee to protect Widows Green Belt, and then goes on to talk about not release or allow council-owned Green Belt land to be developed under any circumstances. Now, as I understand national policy, which is also the current policy, there isn't a policy that says Green Belt land can never be built on under any circumstances. But I go back to the original point, I'm not clear, as a member of this overview and scrutiny, whether we've got the right to actually carry a motion like this, because I don't think we have. So I don't know whether I'm asking you, Chair, or whether the legal people here tonight, but I would like some clarification as to exactly what our role is, and whether we've even got the
terms of the actual the references, I think that Councillor Kenny made a couple of fairly reasonable points, I think. Again, I think that reading through the whole notice of motion and taking up excerpts of it, it's quite clear that we are simply reaffirming the sentiments expressed by the leader of the council in terms of wanting to defend the green belt in the borough, to send a clear message to developers that we will, as a council, not as a committee, but we as a council, wanting to defend those areas of green belt while accepting the points that Councillor Fowkes has made. And lastly, I think as well, I think as a council, we need to be aware of the fact that some of the issues that Councillor Sykes has raised will be addressed to a degree by the proposed housing bill, certainly in terms of reducing the time it takes developers once they've got provision, rather than sitting on land for 3 years, that's going to be reduced to 2 years if the bill is passed, and also the clarity on the exceptional circumstances, which answers the point that Councillor Fowkes and Councillor Kenny made, but also gives this authority, the council, not the committee again, the council, the authority to make it clear to developers what we will and won't tolerate, albeit with exceptional circumstances allowed in the housing bill. So I think the sentiments of the notice of motion are perfectly fair. I think it will send a very clear signal again as a council for this to be passed, whether we do that as a committee or whether we refer it back to council in its entirety, in for the reasons that Councillor Fowkes has outlined.
Of empty homes across the whole of So although we don't have a plan in place as yet, and we're not years behind most of the councils, we are a little behind most of the councils, but we are behind nevertheless. But what we were waiting for, obviously, was for the housing bill, because we had the white paper, the housing bill, and waiting for the housing bill to see what impacts that has. There's also been changes in terms of bedroom tax and other issues that have had to be identified and looked at.
have any ideas of
anything. I concept, Garth Village in Notting is a range of housing across the affordable range from where it is effectively 1,500 houses being developed in Notting. Not saying it's right or wrong, but
Do you know if we have any applications of all those parcels agreed about the will? Comes in,
happens again. The final decision comes down to the committee then, who then look at the same report with the officer's recommendation. The committee then determine, shall we approve it or shall we refuse it? So that's how it stands at the moment. So there are no set criteria what special circumstances. It's in what's in planning officer's head to make a recommendation, and then what the planning committee think is that recommendation vote or not. Are they going to support it or are they going to oppose it? And if they oppose it, the applicant has 6 months in which to submit an appeal to the Secretary of State and not still. And I think really that's all I need to say on this is that, and one final thing, because it's been talked about in the second paragraph when it names a couple of places. We were thrown in for examples, not for anything else. And again, if the head of law thought they shouldn't be in, then he would have told us to take them out. They're simply examples of what is going on. They're not part of the draft, none of them have got planning permission, etc., etc. So they're examples of council-owned land that could be utilised, council-owned green belt land that could be utilised in the green belts. So that's all they are, examples. So I hope you'd accept them as examples, because I think that's what the head of law thought they were, examples. It's not a specific planning application, and I hope I haven't spoken about any specific planning applications tonight. I will urge again committee to support this notice of motion. I do believe it's worthwhile that this committee supports. I do believe it's worthwhile this committee sending it back to council for them to look at, the council to make that decision. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you,
Chair.
Can I just make a point of order, Chair? The point I was making in my contribution was that this overview and scrutiny committee doesn't have the power or the authority to make a decision on green belt land on behalf of the council. The only body who can do that is the full council, which is why I understand it. We're having a debate next Monday night at the special council meeting, and that was the point I was making. Thank you.
Thanks, Chair. As Councillor Blakey's just referred to, the wording in here was we had a call to go forward to a debate, so I moved that the next motion wording as is.
Is it on second?
That's second.
So we're not on that.
it, so we're making progress on some issues that we put forward this year. Sorry if you're just pressed to So, a quick recap, apologies, committee, that's a bit busy. Can you see that in the bright light? Please turn up the lights will turn. Thank you.
Lights.
Is that, all good? Thank you. Sorry. A lot of information on the head. So, just a quick recap, to say the place of Burns by Heart is a attractive work environment for your residents. The way we are attacking or pursuing that pledge is through two underpinning strategies: managing our waste and improving our environment. Managing our waste is the journey that we need to travel to improve our recycling performance and reduce non-recycling waste. And the second is about the way we manage our street scene and the way residents